you think the reverse is possible? Being able to be on the PGA Tour and also competing at an elite level.
Yeah.
Long drive.
That's, I mean, and I don't know how realistic it is. It definitely is something I think about, because if I'm able to, I mean, I would say I'm definitely probably playing the best golf of my life right now, because I've never been able to be Kyle Berkshire, the professional golfer. I've always been either Kyle Berkshire, the student athlete, meaning I had school and golf, or Kyle Berkshire, the long driver, meaning obviously I had long drive and I played golf whenever I could. I never got a chance to put out 99% of my effort and energy into golf. So it would be interesting to see what would happen with my game this winter if I can get it up to that standard. There would be no reason for my long drive swing to decline. So if I've already got that long drive swing at a good place and just maintain it just enough to keep it at that spot and throw all my other efforts and energy into golf, I could possibly see a scenario where, and again, I haven't actually really gotten super deep into this, so this isn't.
Don't
like,
be scared to tell me. I'm sitting here saying I'm going to go be pro and under and play.
Because I played with a lot of guys that are now pros, and when I was a junior golfer, and I played with a lot of pros that are pros like this that are pros on the tour now.
What would you say is that you need to do? Is it, you know, you just need practice, a couple years of?
I would say it's a mixture of developing good technique. My technique has gotten a lot better now that I'm able to focus on training with the right coach, because I have a golf coach, Bernie Najjar. And so we're working on technique, and that's what I spent like 10 hours with him yesterday. So my technique is good, and I have the time now to groove that technique. And it would stand to reason, if I'm able to swing a golf club at a certain speed, then I feel like I have a decent amount of talent. So that I feel like that gives me a good chance at, maybe if I have the right technique, enough time under my belt, and then, you know, and I'm able to get my head in the right spot in the golf course, I feel like I might have a chance. And the fact of the matter is, if the world championship does come back to a place where it's like a big deal, and I think it will in 2021.
Barcelona's good. We're going to
If you guys get behind it, it'll be huge, you know? I mean, and it's one of those things where it could be a scenario where I do pro golf all year, and it could be a very, very viable option to take a week off of pro golf, take that 5-6 days to focus on my long drive swing and prepare for the world championship, and do that every year, the world long drive championship. Because if you're a top long drive guy, it makes financial sense to really get serious, because you're talking about like 6-figure paychecks if you win the world championship in long drive. So, I mean, that would make financial sense. But obviously,
if you are able to win a world championship, you could sustain yourself for the rest of the year to focus and play golf.
You could sustain yourself for probably 2 years, maybe even three.
And is that counting like sponsorships and that type of?
No. So that's just pure prize money. But you know, I think, but it's a concept that I've thought about a lot. But that's probably how it would go. Like, I have the ability to spend a lot of probably 60 hours a week working on my golf game and still keep my long drive swing in a good spot, because obviously I don't want to let that swing fade. And I don't want to like slide down the rankings and start having problems in my long drive. Cause I know that's where my name was made. That's what people know me for. That's my bread and butter. But this is kind of like, I'm trying to add more to it. And I feel like I have the ability, but I think everyone says that, you know, it's a matter of whether you get it done or not. And I definitely want to at least put myself in a position where I have the opportunity to find that out, whether or not I can get it done. And all I'm saying is that I think there's no reason I should say, all right, I'm done with long drive and I'm just doing golf. Because one of my good friends, Jamie Solowski, I don't know if you've heard of him.
I have, through Como, I asked him about you, and he brought up your name, and he brought up him.
And so Jamie, he's a good friend of mine. He's an awesome guy. And but what Jamie did was he retired from long drive to focus on pro golf. And that was, I think, he retired a year before I got into the sport. I think he retired in 2016. And what I guess all I'm saying is, like, I don't see a reason to retire from long drive to focus on golf. I think I'm very capable of staying in the sport of long drive, promoting the sport, growing the sport, doing everything I can to make the sport bigger and get it out there to people the way it needs to, and also have enough time to slowly get my game up to higher levels. And if it ever does reach a point where it's at that level, great. You know, then I can shift my focus to pro golf and still maybe do the World Long Drive Championship every September and focus on that every September. But, you know, a lot of people, when they saw me gearing up for golf, pro golf, they're like, oh, so you're quitting long drive? I'm like, no, I don't have to. Just because I'm, you know, pursuing golf doesn't mean I'm out of long drive. Mm. But I do have room, I think, on my plate to pursue golf while not shoving anything off that plate.
Do you feel like you have a time window? Specifically with the long drive? Because I feel like that's...
For golf, I would say the time window for golf is, I think is pretty generous. A lot of people would say there's an arbitrary age, but I think people sometimes, I think they realize this, but they don't, it doesn't quite register as like distance drops with age. So, but if you're hitting it as far as the young guys and you're like 45, 48, but you're hitting as far as them, then why should you have problems scoring if you're hitting as far, you know?
Right. For regular golf.
Yeah.
But where do you see people start fading off the long drive stuff?
So here's something you're going to be shocked about. The average age of the top 10 in long drive is 33 years old, including me. I'm the youngest person in the top 10 by almost 8 years. There was a 51-year-old who made the final 16 at the World Long Drive Championship last year. And I had him on my TrackMan at Rochester, and he swung 148 miles an hour at the age of 51. Now, what I would say is, I think people see the speed and they're like, oh, that's going to go soon. But there's two types of speed. There's explosive speed and there's agility speed. And I don't think I said it right, but like, so there's speed where you're swinging something very hard using strength. And then there's speed where you're moving your body quick through space and time, like running or moving side to side, like a soccer player. And what I've noticed is if you watch baseball, a lot of past MLB superstars are able to hang on and stay productive as DHs. Like David Ortiz, Jim Thome, because they still had this ability to slug the ball in an incredible way. That was the last thing that left. And they were in their early 40s doing it better than everyone else still. I mean, I think Jim Thome was like – David Ortiz, I think, had like 40-some home runs in his final year, which is incredible. But if you look at home run hitters, they're standing still and swinging something attached to them as hard as they can at a projectile. Mm. In golf, it's the same motion, it's the same mechanics, and I think the staying power of a long driver is actually much better than the staying power of a golfer, in my opinion.
Interesting.
And I would say it goes down to two things. One is we're not slamming the club into the ground all the time; we're hitting it off of a tee, so the impact on our body is actually very small. So if you hit a bunch of iron shots and you're slamming your wrist repeatedly into the ground, that's a lot more force to absorb than just picking it off a tee. The other thing is, yes, we swing these clubs, you know, tremendously fast, but they're also very light. And because it's a lighter object, it's not pulling away from our body as hard as an iron would or, you know, even a wedge. So I think the impact is much lower. And I'll say this, I've had much, much less to little, no aches and pains and long drive, but I have had an injury here and there as a junior golfer playing golf. I've never... ever had an injury worth mentioning in long drive ever.